Well, when it comes to knowing what's going on in your own backyard here in Lake Tahoe, you don't want any gray area. So tune in the Tahoe Today Show each and every single morning at 7 o'clock. We go all the way till 9:30 with weather, road conditions, and more. See you then. I'm here talking to Pat at Bobo's in Reno, right on Moana Lane, and we are going to get some information about some really good ideas for all mountain skis, especially since we've had our first dusting. I bet everybody is just jonesing.
Everyone is so excited for the cooling off and the fresh dusting, the first dusting of the year. People are starting to turn their sights back onto skiing. It's getting cooler. The night days are getting shorter. It's a good sign. I hope it continues. It'd be great if the season was like last year, and we have powder every day, so we'll see what happens.
I think a lot of people want that too.
Yeah, we're off to a good start. So I wanted to talk real quickly about maybe how you go about choosing an all-mountain ski, because there's a lot of all-mountain skis, and even within brands, there are the same width. So the slight difference between the two skis, even though they're the same width, how do you go about picking a 100-millimeter bull ski like the Bonafide versus the Rustler, even though they're the same brand? They're two distinct personalities. And I want to just talk about it real briefly today. So Blizzard makes phenomenal skis. They're Austrian-made skis, solid wood core, two sheets of metal. But even within those parameters, these skis are made for the best skiers on the mountain, but there are different personalities. Even though they are the same width, the Bonafide that you have in your hands has a solid two sheets of metal, solid wood core, vertical sidewall, and is made for real aggressive skiers, so it's real damp, real stable, has incredible edge hold, a lot of versatility. You'll see them all over the mountains. Got a new paint job this year. It looks beautiful. Mm-hmm. Within that same market, you have the Rustler. It's all not the strongest ski is this ski. This ski has got a little bit more rocker in the tip and tail, so it's a little bit more forgiving. It initiates turns easier, it exits the turn a little bit easier with the rocker tail, and it's a little bit more forgiving, less fatiguing, maybe for a skier that's over 50, but they still want to have good performance, or they've had some injuries in the past, or just looking for something easier. The Rustler is a really good choice. It still has metal in the ski, so it's got a lot of damp forgiveness, just like metal. Metal vibrates, filters out the vibration, makes the ski quieter, but instead of doing a solid sheet on the tip throughout the whole ski, top and bottom, they put it underneath the foot and just a little bit in the tip and a little bit in the tail. So the ski has a lot of damp. It's just not as it's more forgiving. Mm-hmm. It's not as aggressive. So that's kind of the difference between the two.
Pat, that's amazing. And I have to say that that's exactly why you want to come to Bobo's to get any winter equipment, because you're coming for this level of expertise and this level of precise information. Thank you so much for your time. Appreciate it, Pat.
You're welcome. See you on the slopes.
See you there.